everyone, my name is Maita and welcome back to my channel. This video is a video that's part of a 30-day challenge where I try to upload one video a day every day for 30 days. It's 10:30 p.m. something like that, and I'm just about to wrap up my day after my last meeting, which started at 9 p.m. and I thought I would walk you through my process for starting the day and ending the day using my daily review. If you watched my video 2 days ago, I talked through a weekly review and I went through some properties that rolled up to that weekly review that you saw. So I'm gonna be running through the daily review, and that shows those different data points and fields that you add in every day that eventually roll up to the weekly review, the quarterly review, and the yearly review. I'm doing this at the end of the day, but I am going to show you what I do at the beginning of the day and then just talk you through what I do to close the day out. The platform of choice is Notion, and this template is largely based on August Bradley's template, but I have tweaked it a bit to work with what I do on a day-to-day basis and kind of just add in some little details that I've picked up from different people. So starting here in my command center, I go to the action zone. So this really houses all the information that I refer to daily. This is actually the page in my entire Notion space that I refer to the most. It's usually the first thing that I open on my computer every morning. So up here on top is everything that I'm currently working on that's ingrained as part of my daily routine or habits. So that includes what I'm currently reading. I also indicate what I'm currently writing, what I'm currently learning. I'm in between two courses at the moment, and honestly, I haven't made progress in either of them just because of the other priorities on my day-to-day tasks. And then finally, what I'm currently filming as part of this YouTube challenge. Today, I'm working on video 20. So this quote is a quote that I found from an article that I read on Medium, and it was talking about how this writer lost electricity at 10:30 a.m. It forces me to prioritize my tasks and eat the frog first. Do the most important things in the morning before 10:30. So this part is a daily tracking part. This is the first thing that I fill out every morning. And what I do is I add in the month, the week, the title is essentially the date, and then the day, so Wednesday. And then I scroll down and I try to find the relevant date of Wednesday, April 28th. I also indicate my start feels, however I'm feeling when I start the day. And those are the first pieces of information that I add in every morning. The rest I will add in typically at the end of the day, or maybe if I refer to this, I'll check it off as I go along throughout my day. So I like to keep track of things like prayer and meditation, exercise, reading, fasting. I mentioned this in my weekly review, and those at the end of the week get averaged out or get counted to see just how well I kept up with my habits throughout the week. The night before, I do this as part of my wrap-up routine, but I like to already identify the tasks that I'm going to be working on for the next day, and I prioritize them in terms of importance and urgency. So that's how I start my day. I remind myself of what I'm currently working on in terms of habits and routines that I want to keep track of, and also what I need to tackle when it comes to work or personal to-dos. So then at the end of the day, for example now, I'll go back to this daily tracking and I'll tick off everything that I actually did. Today I was able to pray, I went for a walk, I fasted for 16 hours, I haven't been able to read or journal yet. This 30 day is for the 30 day video, so I will be able to tick that off later. And then I'll add in the sleep, which I actually should have done earlier this morning. Normally, I will also keep track of my food calories and my exercise calories, but I haven't really been doing that lately. And my weight, I do measure because it is one of my quarterly projects, but I just do that once a week, which is on a Sunday, so I don't have anything to add in here. So before I answer the output and day rating, I will go down to my action items and check off everything that I was able to do. So today I was able to actually finish my 3 priority tasks. Unfortunately, I didn't do all the quick tasks that I was set out to do. And what I'll usually do in that case is I'll just move it to tomorrow, and then it removes it from the to-do today list. And then based on the action items, that's when I'll fill in the output rating and the day rating. The output is what percentage of work do I think I got done. In this case, I'll just put an 80% of work. And then the day rating on a scale of 1 to 5, how did it go? It wasn't a bad day. And then I quickly express through a fitting emoji how I feel at the end of the day. At the moment, I still feel really sleepy after a long day. I like to put what improvements I can make. And this I got from Ali Abdal, The Daily Story. I decided to add this in because staying at home really throughout this pandemic has become so monotonous. It's nice to remind yourself that you can make a daily story day to day. You don't have to have big stories and big things happening in your life all the time. So I'll add in like a sentence or two of something that describes my day. So again, these daily tracking data points roll up into my weekly review where I can see the completion rate of my different habits. It's just really a reminder for me to stay on track and keep in mind what are the things that are important to me and what I want to be doing daily. Once that's done, I will then review what I need to be tackling tomorrow. In this drop-down menu are all the actions that I need to do for the next day. What I'll do then is I'll make sure that everything is filed and labeled correctly. I will pick out priorities, and what will happen is tomorrow when I open up Notion, the to-dos will automatically be a today to-do. Sometimes what I'll do is I'll plan based on this upcoming calendar view. It's very easy to drag and drop. So here you can see that I can just easily move these blocks and it automatically updates the dates depending on where you drag them. I love this view actually because it gives me a quick glance and allows me to move things around, especially for projects that have timelines that change. It's easy to move around things. And finally, it's nice to be able to see how this rolls up into projects and yearly goals and value goals. I've already talked about my thought process behind this in the video of how I set goals as a systems thinker. So if you're interested in how those were identified, I recommend you check that video out. So that's it for now, just a quick wind down video as I wrap up the day. I hope this helped you. Don't forget to like and subscribe if it did, and I'll see you tomorrow.